But the father was too smart. He had to have some serious doubts, but he kept Chester in jail for decades anyway. And that's a pretty despicable thing to do for no other reason than hubris. This is a screenwriter's take on the new HBO documentary, The Murders at Starved Rock. And there's gonna be lots of spoilers. This documentary is ostensibly about three murders in rural Illinois in the 1960s, but it's really about the relationship between a father and son. For the first 2.5 hours of this series, I kept wondering, why would the son, who was the driving force behind the documentary, want to show what an asshole his father was? His father was the prosecutor who put Chester in jail for three murders. And for the first 2.5 hours of the series, every indication is that the case was extremely flimsy. But then the last 30 minutes are spent discrediting all of the people who thought Chester was innocent and offering a wild cock and bull story out of left field about how even if Chester wasn't the killer, he might still have been involved or knew the killer or knew who the killer was. And somewhat strangely, the documentary ends a few months before the DNA test results come back to either prove or disprove Chester's innocence. But that's the point. We all know the DNA evidence is going to exonerate Chester. So the son has to get out front of the story and offer some plausible explanation as to why his father believed Chester was guilty, even when the DNA evidence will probably point the other way. That's the screenwriter lesson. Good stories are not about events like a triple murder. Good stories are about people and relationships. The son has to wrestle with the fact that his father most likely let an innocent man rot in jail for 60 years. That's the story, and it's good storytelling.